CBS News, otherwise known as the Clinton Broadcast System, has a clear agenda it must adhere to at all costs. They strive to make Republicans look as bad as possible while they shower praise on Democrats. This is no coincidence. The mainstream media is a vile cesspool of liberal bias because the executives of major outlets all have ties to individuals in both the Obama and Clinton administrations. David Roadies, the current president of CBS News, is the brother of Ben Roadies, a former White House national security adviser under Obama. The largest contribution that Ben Roadies provided to the Obama administration was his role in the editing of the Benghazi talking points, which were read on air by Susan Rice after the attack. With this level of corruption, it's no wonder that when President Trump graciously agreed to an interview with CBS, the organization used it as an opportunity to attack the president. President Donald Trump's sit-down with Face the Nation grew heated this weekend when CBS John Dickerson insulted the commander-in-chief in the Oval Office. After Dickerson's line of questioning got seriously out of hand, chaos erupted, and Trump decided to abruptly end the interview. During the interview, John Dickerson blatantly tries to turn the conversation towards Obama in an attempt to fluster and anger the president, even though Trump answers every question factually. Dickerson doesn't even acknowledge the truth behind Trump's complaint that Obama placed him under surveillance. Instead, the so-called journalist tried to bring up Trump's past statements on Obama. These repeated attempts to provoke the president were incredibly disrespectful. President Trump was right to call Obama sick and bad. Not only did Obama try to destroy the country, he truly did place Trump under surveillance, a fact that has been proven multiple times, despite the media's efforts to suppress it. For his part, President Trump displayed an astonishing level of patience and civility towards the antagonistic interviewer, even as he told him to leave. Where was the media's hyper-scrutiny of the president while Obama was in office? The media's antics to smear President Trump didn't work during the election, and they won't work now. Share this on Facebook and Twitter and let us know what else you think. What are your thoughts on this? Please share them with the world. Patriot Journal helped contribute to this report. It's News Exposed signing off.